that area. We don't look right into the womb of the adjacent area. See what the oxygen flow there is. If it's less than 40 millimeters of mercury, aha! That may be the reason we're not getting enough oxygen out there. Preoperatively, we have a patient with a osteomyelitis in the great toe. And the surgeon wants to just do a great toe amputation, but they give a history of vascular insufficiency. You can amputate that great toe. What about those postoperative flaps that's starting to look dusty? You know, we transported skin, subcutaneous fat, fascia, and its blood supply from point A to point B. Now at point B, it's looking dusty. Is it getting enough blood flow? Check that out. And we're worried if it's 40 millimeters of mercury or less. Same thing holds true with reimplants. It's a big flap when you do a reimplant. Hyperbaric medicine physicians quite often will do pre-hyperbaric therapy transcutaneous oximetry. And they're checking to see, one, is if this individual will be a candidate. They actually have a stress test that I outlined in the handout for you. If they're a candidate for hyperbaric oxygen, and they can use the TCOM as an endpoint of therapy. How about some specific tests for specific etiology? Well, the neuropathic, diabetic neuropathic ulcer on the plantar aspect of the foot is felt due to peripheral neuropathy due to the diabetes. So how do we check for the sensation? The method of choice would be the Sens-Weinstein monofilament test. You check 10 spots on the foot. If you notice, 9 of the 10 are on the plantar aspect. One is at the first web space, and you check them. And this is a technique that you put a 10-gauge monofilament wire, and you crumple it up, or you make a U out of it, and the patient has to tell you whether they feel it or not. Now, long-term care in an Alzheimer unit, forget it. You're not going to be able to get that cooperation, unfortunately. Now, if you start having areas that are insensated, usually it's around the first or the third toe initially, then the American Diabetes Association suggests that yearly foot examinations need to be done routinely on diabetics. However, this is a factor that you want to do more frequently than yearly if they start having an insensated foot. The Sens-Weinstein monofilament test. Sickle cell patients, they have these ulcers. They look superficial. They are associated with venous insufficiency. But they hurt, which doesn't go along with venous insufficiency. They occur in very, very young black and Hispanics, 10 to 35 years of age. That doesn't go along with venous insufficiency or arterial or even pyoderma gangrenosum. It just doesn't go along with it. We think they may have a sickle cell ulcer. How do we prove it? 25 to 70% of the people with sickle cell disease, the disease is the homozygous, where basically all their hemoglobin is the abnormal hemoglobin, will at one point in time develop these ulcers. What happens is that the normal hemoglobin will make the red blood cell by concave and it will flow through the capillary.